Hi, I'm Jim Oberhofer, and welcome to Coletta Motorsports. And today I'm going to give you a behind-the-scenes look at how we use Mack Tools to build that 11,000 horsepower Mack Tools top fuel dragster. You know, in the sport of NHRA drag racing, sometimes races are separated by less than 1/10,000th of a second. So for us here at Coletta Motorsports, we wanted to take everything we could, bring it in-house, and control our own destiny. So I'm going to take you through and show you some of those things that we have built over the last 5 to 10 years to take Coletta Motorsports and this Mack Tools team to the top of the heap. One of the first and most important steps to building that 10,000 horsepower Mack Tools top fuel dragster is actually building the chassis. Here at Coletta Motorsports at the Bounty Hunter Chassis Shop, we have our own state-of-the-art dragster chassis jig that we use 4130 chromoly steel welded together by the best welders in the world. Something that's new to Coletta Motorsports is our state-of-the-art CNC machine shop where we build everything from clutches to cylinder heads along with another 450 parts. There's a lot of parts and pieces that go into making 10 or 11,000 horsepower in this Mack Tools top fuel dragster. There's a short block, there's cylinder heads, there's superchargers, manifolds, all sorts of parts, plus a lot of little parts too. After you're done assembling that engine that makes 10 or 11,000 horsepower, somehow you got to apply all that power to the ground, and the way you do that is through a 6-disc, 10.5-inch centrifugal clutch. After you're done making 10, 11,000 horsepower with your engine, and then you're driving it through the clutch, somehow you got to get all that power to the racetrack surface. How do you do that? With a 12-inch rear end and a 36-inch tall, 17.5-inch Goodyear tire. When you're making 10,000 horsepower, you can't burn just regular gasoline. You have to burn nitromethane. You use a fuel pump that flows about 110 gallons per minute. And on a normal run in the Mack Tools top fuel dragster, we'll go through about 15 gallons of fuel on the entire run, from burning out to backing up to staging and making that 330 mile an hour run. What gives that Mack Tools top fuel dragster all that personality is a carbon fiber body. We build the body, we attach it to the frame with Zeus buttons, and then the last thing that goes on is all that cool Mack Tools branding. We've talked about all the parts and pieces that it takes to build this 10,000 horsepower Mack Tools dragster, but somebody has to put this stuff together. For me, I have the best crew in drag racing. I have the Mack Tools team back here, and they do an amazing job on this Mack Tools car. Not only are Mack Tools great to work with, but so are these guys. That was just a sneak peek at what it takes to build this 10, 11,000 horsepower Mack Tools top fuel dragster. So you really need to come to the NHRA drag races and see what this Mack Tools car is like up close and in person.